How's it going, everyone? We are back, and today we're going to be hitting some arms. The last arm workout I did was more of a bicep tricep superset, so we're going to switch things up this time, and we're going to go for all triceps to start, a few supersets, a few not, and then we're going to go into all biceps. The main reason behind that is because I want to focus a little bit more on triceps in terms of development, so I like to start with the muscle that I want to focus on a little bit more. So if you're in the situation where you want to focus a bit more on your biceps, start with the bicep portion of the workout, okay? So what we're going to start off with is we're going to go for a simple exercises, but I'm going to try to switch it up a little bit in terms of angles, okay? So we're going for a lying dumbbell tricep extension. We're going to be coming straight down, but when we're coming up, we're going to be rotating around. Normally, in my past videos, I don't do any real rotation. It's just straight up, straight down. We're going to focus on coming down nice and slow, getting a good stretch at the bottom, and then powering up. Another little change with this is we're going to have our head off the bench. Now, that's just going to allow for a little bit more of a stretch, okay? So we're going to go for 12 reps. Now, what we want to do is we want to start this exercise off by applying tension to the tricep before we even start the movement. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to angle the entire arm back a little bit. This is going to be our start position. We're going to try and maintain this position as well, okay? So from this position here, we're going to lower it right down, keeping the elbows nice and tucked in. Powering up, rotating around, squeezing as hard as we can at the top. Down, elbows in.
I've got a question, if you'd hear me out, in your defense, you never had a chance, and so tell me straight, I won't go, this is our time now, I'm sure, make no mistake, that we are.
Okay, with this exercise, it's a real good way to take yourself beyond fatigue or focus more on the eccentric. So I want to give you guys a little tip. When you're coming down on this exercise and you get to here and you're on the last few reps and you just can't push up while maintaining good technique. So when you're pushing up, the elbows coming out, we're looking shocking, okay? Best way to do it is drop the dumbbells to the chest, use the chest to press the dumbbell up, and then come back down, focusing on coming nice and slow. That allows you to not only fatigue through the concentric, which is this portion of the movement, but also the eccentric, which is this portion of the movement here, coming down.
Embrace for impact, fight your fears aside, embrace for impact.
Okay guys, you saw there when I was using that push up to help me with those last few reps, okay? And the key is, when you are coming down, because we've missed out this portion of the exercise, really make the most of it, okay? Really make the most of that coming down. So what I generally do, down halfway, and just hold that weight until it forces you down into that bottom position, bring it to the chest.
I've got a question, if you hear me out, in your defense, you never had a chance, and so tell me straight, I won't go, this is our time now, I'm sure, make no mistake, that we are closer than we're far. Embrace for impact, fight your fears aside. Embrace for impact, I'm a future's engineer. And baby, I'm here, I'm here. And baby, I'm here, I'm here.
with a cable kickback like this. Bending over, keeping the nice straight back. Keeping the elbow elevated, okay? This part of the arm here shouldn't really be moving. The only part that should be moving is the forearm. So we're extending out. What people love to do is they love to move the shoulder and use the shoulder to help you out. If you feel like you are using the shoulder, it's too heavy, just drop it down, okay? So we don't want to see any of this, okay? It turns into a bit more rear delts. We want to stay up in that position there. Extend out, nice big squeeze, and in, okay? Try it out, guys. Okay, guys, next exercise is the good old tricep push down with the rope. Now, we're gonna switch this up a little bit. We're going for 30 reps total. And that's gonna be split up into basically 3 sets of 10, but with no rest, okay? And all we're gonna be doing is manipulating the angle. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come right out here. So take 3 nice big steps back. 2 nice big steps back. Okay. From here, we're gonna do 10 reps, making sure our elbows are locked into the side of our body, okay? And extending the rope right down. 10 reps.
If you'd hear me out, out in your defense, you never had a chance. And so tell me straight, I won't go. This is our time.
Once those 10 are done, 1 step in, okay? Another 10. Finish it off, right on. At this point here, you're gonna wanna let go. Go. One of the most important parts of this exercise is to not let the elbows drift. This is one of the most common things that I see when I watch anyone do tricep push down, is they let the elbow drift and they pump down. They let the elbow drift and then they pump down, okay? What we wanna do, we wanna keep that arm fixed into the side, fixed right in, chest up, and we're extending right down the bottom, almost trying to tear that rope apart, okay? Also, you don't want to lean over and start using the shoulders yet. Keep the shoulders back. Give it a go, 10, 10, 10. Okay, guys. Next, we're on the first exercise for biceps, which is a Scott curl or a preacher curl. Now, the difference we're gonna do with this exercise is we're gonna go for a pause for about 1 to 2 seconds at the bottom range of the movement. Now, the reason we're doing that is making sure that we're fully locking out, because one of the most common areas people go wrong with this exercise is it's a partial range of motion, okay? So what we wanna do is wanna be in this position here, fully lock out at the bottom, 1, 2, power it up. Also, we're not gonna be going all the way up to the top, okay? As soon as we go far up, the tension travels straight down through the elbow, and then the tension comes off the bicep. What we wanna do is we wanna stop the movement about there, just so that we can keep the tension on the bicep the entire time, okay? So when we're on this exercise, triceps are always in contact with the bench. We're going for a closer grip. Okay, guys. Going for the second set, we're gonna switch it up just a little bit, okay? We're gonna keep that pause at the bottom, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna let the rest get a little bit lazy, okay? And what that does is it just helps intensify the contraction at the top of the movement, okay? And I'll show you what I mean by that. So we're going for that pause, we're coming up, and you see how my wrist is kind of flowing back a little bit. That's gonna give you an extra bit more of a squeeze. Coming down, one, two, up, squeeze. One, two, up, squeeze, good. This exercise, we're hitting 10 to 12 reps for 4 sets, okay? Depending on how much you want to switch things up, you can change the pause time at the bottom. Go from anywhere from 1 to 5 seconds, depending on if you've done it before or not, okay? 5 seconds is obviously going to be a little bit harder, so gauge it, start off with 1 to 2 and then work your way up.
Okay, good.
Alright guys, onto the second bicep exercise, which is going to be a superset, alternate dumbbell curls, superset with a barbell reverse curl, okay? And that's mainly for brachialis. So what we're going to do with this first exercise, we're going to go 10 on the first one, 12 on the second one, 3 sets total. We're going to be starting off in a neutral grip, which means dumbbells facing this way, and then we're going to come up and rotate. Supinated grip, okay? And now we're gonna really try and force that supination at the top. So I'll really try and pull that pinky over the shoulder, okay? And then coming up for the second one. Just 10 reps each side on this. Making sure our chin and chest is up. When we're coming down, we're rotating the dumbbells back to that neutral grip position. Most other bicep exercises doesn't really apply to cables because cables there is constant tension pulling. But any dumbbell barbell stuff, we are restricting that range of motion at the top, so we're only coming to about there, we're not coming all the way up, okay? That's one of the most important things. Now with this reverse curl, we're making sure that our grip is about shoulder width so that we can keep our elbows tucked in. Okay, we want to keep our elbows tucked into the side. Coming right up. So with these two exercises, we're limiting any swinging, okay? We want to keep the knees kind of locked in position, elbows locked in position, and we're not doing any momentum squeezing. Core's in nice and tight, we're just using those arms. Let's go. Okay guys, we're going to finish this entire workout off with a bicep tricep superset. Just to switch it up a little bit. I know I didn't say we were going to do that, but we are. So, both machines we're going to go for because my sister wants to get home and she's like, Jordan, stop talking for too long. We're gonna go double arm rather than single arm. I wanted to go single arm. But, so we're gonna be back in this position. Straight up, nice big squeeze. Full stretch. Just going for 10 reps, 3 sets. This song's quite fitting, isn't it? I didn't get it from my dad, Justin. The only body part that I wish that I got from my dad is his calves. And the bastard will never, ever, ever let me live that down, I swear to God. And then we jumped on triceps. 10 reps, 12 reps. Like any tricep, we're keeping the elbows locked in. Try not to push through the shoulders, because it's easy on a lot of tricep exercises to drive through the shoulders.